Genevieve Nnaji, thanks for joining.
Thank you for having me.
If you have to make a point, as you said you usually do, about the situation of your country now, and more specifically about the situation of children, what would that point be?
I come from a very large family, and we all have been privileged to experience the joy of growing up as children and into adulthood. And that is a right that it seems is being taken away from some of the children out there, especially those in the north. The messed up part is children only have a time in their life when they can actually speak up for themselves and, you know, claim their rights and do what they want. And that's when they hit the age of 18. Until then, their lives are usually controlled by parents, guidance, school teachers, anyone who's older than you will tell you what to do. That is a joy that I must say, honestly, you're taking away from the lives of these children. They will never be adults because before they even have the right to speak, you know, they're plucked off and married off.
Nigeria has one of the highest rates of early marriage in the world. How can these girls be better protected?
I think for starters, you know, let girls grow up to become women and make a choice of what they want. Even if you're going to arrange their marriage, at least get them to the point where they know who they are as a human being, as a woman, discover for themselves, and they can be able to fight for themselves when they're being abused in their home, if it comes to that. It's important that we do not set ourselves back 100 years. You know, we have fought as women, as African women, to get to where we are and be liberated and fight for equality, you know, in our society.
You come from a middle-class family, in a country with increased inequality. How was the Nigeria you grew up in as a girl? And as a girl, were you scared of such big issues for children here, such as child early marriage?
I had my kid at a very young age, and if this was something that stood, I would be married. I would have been married off by now. You know, I obviously would probably have grandchildren at this point. But that didn't happen, basically, because I was given that chance. That's why there's a Genevieve today. That's why I'm sitting in this chair today. You know, and I am forever grateful that this didn't happen in my era. And knowing what life I have and how much I've been able to accomplish, it breaks my heart to know that you're probably ending the life of the possibility of someone who is going to probably find a cure for cancer right now because she's married off.
How can you use more your influence for the benefit of society?
There's only so much you can do as an individual. I'm not a politician, unfortunately. I'm an artist, and what I do is entertain. But I only have my body to tell a story and myself as a human being. At the end of the day, I am the brand, so I'm going to use this brand to express myself in the most honest way I can. I want to believe that I stand as a woman and I stand as a sample, an example as a strong woman for these young and up-and-coming women. I think it's important that children, especially women who do not have a future or who do not have hope for a future, look and see that it's not all lost. Genevieve came from nothing, and here she is. She's something today. So I want my life to be a testimony to theirs. The only thing I can do is continue to succeed as much as I can, continue to push the envelope, and continue to say, you know what? One person is enough.
You see yourself as an example for other women in terms of having succeeded, doing what you always dreamed of doing, mm-hmm. being a mother, having married who you wanted to marry, and that most women in Nigeria don't have that privilege. How do you get there then? How can you make that happen for women in Nigeria?
I can only lend my voice and speak up like I'm doing right now and saying this is what I think. And if you're a respecter of who I am as a person, you should understand that this affects each and every one of us as citizens of this country.
Girls' empowerment and women's empowerment mm-hmm. is essential for the future of Africa.
Yes.
The government in Nigeria has shown some openness in the issue and created, for example, the National Commission for Women and a Ministerial Portfolio for Women Affairs. Mm-hmm. Is that far-reaching enough?
No, but it's a starting point. It's endless, you know. It's we're part of the economy. The economy is growing. And that is going to continue to grow for a very long time. And I don't think it's okay to just say we've established this organization and that institution and blah, blah, blah. And it should end there. It shouldn't end there. It should be a starting point and it should continue for as long as, you know, we can. But then we need to come together as a people and not wait for the government alone to do things.
Is the solution with individuals or with government?
It's with government. The solution is with government. I think, the people have to revamp their way of thinking and be a bit more positive and a bit more supportive, especially towards those who are even doing something at all. Now, as for the government, unfortunately, we have more people who are more about themselves and less about the people. If we love this country like we claim we do, we will do more for the country and less for ourselves. So the people in power need to start to love the country. I think they have taken enough money for themselves, quite honestly. And I think it's time that they start to give back to those they've taken from.
You go out in the streets, you see a lot of poverty. How does that affect you? Do you feel like an outcast in your own country?
It's almost like whatever problem I think I have becomes trivial. For me, that's courage. I think they're the strongest. Those people who are in that situation and still smiling, they're the strongest. Because a lot of us, probably with our wealth, are still unhappy. We're not even half as happy as they are because they're content. But then contentment does not mean they can't have a better life, and which is obviously why we're talking about this.
What kind of country do you hope your daughter will grow up in?
Well, obviously, it has to be a place where independence in the true sense of the meaning reigns, where people are free to express without being shut down, without being called names, where people have a freedom of opinion. But it has to be a country where people are open and people are unafraid to speak up. It's not that place yet. So I wish for Africa what America has.
Do you believe that the people in Africa and in Nigeria are working hard as well to have that integration, that union that is necessary to progress and to make it a better continent?
No, the people are the problem. We don't know what we want as a people. We want this, but we're not ready to do the work to get there. You want to be respected. You want to be an achiever, but you're not ready to put in the work. And if someone puts in the work and gets there, oh no, they didn't get there by hard work. They must have gotten it by these means because you were unable to achieve what they did. So it's the mentality of us that kills us. So I don't think even us, we say we're ready, but our attitude does not show that at all.
Genevieve Nnaji,
yes.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you.